Hey guys, Captain Kevin here on the 79 Sea Ray Weekender. Working on the decals and naming the boat still. But in my last video I talked about the whole boat in general, and I did mention that the sound system was kind of shot. Mitch maxed and just basically didn't work well. So I went online and ordered a new one. And I'm going to go ahead and go through it here, and I'm going to be installing it today in a beautiful June Monday afternoon. Alright, so we're at the back of the boat here, and I'm going to show you. I got everything laid out here, what I'll be installing. And first off, we got here is a Rockville gauge style receiver, and it actually has a remote that you can mount anywhere else in the boat as well, which is kind of nice. Comes with a 32-foot cable for pretty much mounting anywhere you want to. For now, I'll be mounting this next to the cockpit instead of in the dash. I'm working on actually rebuilding the dash in this off season, but for now, I'll be mounted to the side. Next, we got this 2400-watt Rockville Marine Amp 4-channel. Came with this cool little mic here with PA system attached to it, which is kind of cool. Next we got this Rockville Marine 10-inch sub, which is pretty sweet. And then right next to it, we got two sets, which is basically four of these 8-inch, I think they're 400-watt power speakers. Now the cool thing of these Rockville speakers and the sub is that after I get it all hooked up, they actually have LED lighting in it that's interchangeable, and you can match it all up with one or two remotes and have all the speakers in the sub all matching colors lighting up at night, which is pretty sweet. So basically right now I've got 6-inch subs, 6-inch speakers I should say, four of them in the back here, and then the 10-inch sub right there in the middle. And then this, I gotta fix this as well. This is another project here, but that's the other one right there. And when I get it mounted back up to where it goes, after I pulled out all that wet rot wood. And then the sub, I don't have it open right this second. Let's see here. Or not the sub, but the amp will get remounted back here as well. Obviously that's a big one back there, but we'll be switching it out there. So that's today's project here. You know, for those who know me, back when I was in the Army, I did a few of these audio stereos, but shoot, I've been out of the Army 15 years now, and I haven't done one in a long time, just, you know, kids, life, everything. So I'm pretty excited to be able to put this together on the boat. You know, you notice it's all Rockville, all marine grade system. The crazy thing is, this entire package, everything you see here, $450. So you can easily spend that on a 10-inch solo barrack sub, just the sub itself. So I was pretty excited to be able to get this all set up here for under $500. So it's going to take me a few hours, and I'll once I get going on the project and getting the old system out, I'll do another video or update on here, and we kind of go from there. Alright guys, I'm back. I've been at it for about a half hour or so. I was able to get this speaker here already in place. Biggest thing was that I had to pull this panel out a little bit more. Get my jigsaw involved and cut the hole bigger. This fabric, or I don't even call it, but vinyl is really delicate here, so just got to be careful trimming it around. As you can tell, just in the speaker, there's a lot of lip there, so I'm able to staple it back into place. So that was the first one. I don't have it wired up yet, but I'm going to do that last after everything mounted. The second one I'm working on right now, like I said, these were 6-inch speakers, and now we're going to 8-inch speakers. So, you know, I'm going to cut the hole a little bit bigger, so I was able to line up the template up to the top of this rail here, tape it in place, and now I'll have a nice easy blade to cut the hole out with the jigsaw. It's gonna be a lot easier on this one than it was on the last one, just because I've got this template and I'm not having to hold that piece in place. So just a little bit of update, and we'll keep on working. Alright guys, so I got this hole cut out. One thing I didn't mention to you before is that whenever you are cutting on a boat or pretty much anywhere in life, make sure you know what's right behind it. So, I don't know if you can see it, but look at this. Right behind this hole, right behind where the speaker goes, that's the fuel line for the intake. So, take extra precaution and slow down when you're cutting these holes. If I just went gung-ho and not really paid attention, I would have easily cut that gas line, and that would have been a world of trouble. So take special precaution whenever you're cutting any type of holes, okay? I'm getting ready to wire in this one here now that I got that done. So we got two connections on this one, obviously. The first one is your main speaker line, which, you know, if you've done any speaker work, you know what it is. The other one here is the LED power, all right, which kind of goes along with this little remote here as well. And I'll show that after when it's all set up and done. Real easy connection, and I'm able to basically piggytail the whole setup together to like a daisy chain, basically, with all the speakers and the sub. One thing I did do was I put a little bit of electrical tape around this connection here just so it doesn't come apart for any reason. You can get waterproofing tape, you know, shrink wrap tape, whatever you want to do. I just had electrical tape. I think that should be sufficient for what this is. Like I said, it is all marine grade as well. So, all right, I'm going to continue on with the project, and I'll keep you all updated. All right, guys, so it's about 3:30. I've been working for about 2.5 hours. I just finished mounting the last speaker, which total of 4 speakers and one sub. It's not really mounted because, obviously, this one is not where it's supposed to be, and that's because I got to finish that whole section still. But at least it's mounted where it's supposed to be at. Genius me didn't bring my shop vac out here, so now I got a whole bunch of wood all over and dust all over the back of the boat, but that'd be a problem for another day, I guess. So I'll work on that a little bit later. Now I'm gonna start tackling the amp. First thing I'm gonna do though is, and also when I was cutting this whole cutting this speaker out, the starboard back side, you know how I told you watch out for those that fuel line, right? Well, look what's there. Also that damn 4-gauge power supply to the amp. So I had to make sure I didn't cut that either. That would have been electrifying if I did. But that was, we worked that out pretty good. So now we're going to work on getting this taken out, this big old thing, and put a nice slim one that's a lot more powerful, and kind of go from there. All right, so I got to get on the take out, put all this stuff up here, and disconnect the battery so I don't shock myself doing this process, and I'll talk to y'all later. Alright guys, I'm back here. Just went and took out the old amp. It's a Boston amp, is all it says. I don't know the ampage on this thing at all, or water, or whatever you want to call it. But, so now we got the new one in here, another, that's Rockville here. It's considerably smaller, obviously. I think it's 2400 watts on this amp. Be able to run the same wiring, you know, and if you actually do wiring and stuff and electrical, you'll notice that I put these caps on here. Well, that's because I didn't go down and unplug it from the battery after all. Didn't feel like doing all that, but that'll work. One concern that I have here that I'm going to have to find a remedy for is, you know, see this rocket, fishing rocket that was installed? Well, obviously being an old boat, that cover, like this one has, is missing. So what that means is that when it rains, which it rains here in Monroe, up here in Michigan quite often, is that water's going to come straight down into here, into this bottom of the rocker. And of course, you know, there's a hole at the bottom there. In most places, you know, for boats, water get on it, not a problem. I prefer water not dripping on top of the amp. And I'm sure you would too. So what I'm thinking for temporarily is I'm just going to get like a water bottle and cut the top off of it and kind of tape it to that and just kind of check on it to see, like tape it right here just so it catches the water for now, and if that works I can just constantly watch it and dump it out as needed. And if it doesn't work, I'll have to come up with a better solution, but definitely don't want water coming in from rain. Even with the car, the top on, don't want to come in through that rocket and drip it on the amp. So, although it is a marine amp, so let's protect it, you know, do the best you can to keep it dry. All right, I'm going to continue on installation of the wiring now of the amp and move on to the gauge radio and Bluetooth and the whole nine yards. So, all right, I'll be back. All right, guys, I'm back. I got a chance to take a look at the wiring for the new gauge mount radio and receiver. Of course, it did not come with all the wiring I needed, but I can actually use some of the wiring from the existing radio, which is right here. You notice I already had to take out the captain's seat and move that back up out of my way, because behind this panel is the receiver and also all the connections for the receiver, including this blue remote line. So I'm going to go ahead and take some time, take this apart, which it's not the first time I've taken it apart. I did that when I was stripping out of the wood and when I was hooking up the GPS as well. So it's not too hard. I'm going to go in. This is my current location for mounting the radio, the receiver unit right now. It could go here, but the only problem is behind here there is no clearance. It's actually pretty big if you didn't notice it. And behind us is only about 3 to 4 inch gap between that and the shower wall. So there's not much clearance behind here. For now, I'm gonna mount it here. And eventually when I get done on the off season rebuilding this this dashboard with some nice teak wood custom made, I'll find a place to mount it up on here, up on the dash. But for right now, let's go with right there. So I'll talk to you all in a little bit when I get this all taken apart and start getting things installed again. So guys, I just finished fishing out the old harness, and I was going to put it all back together, but I figured I'll show you guys what's behind this panel here real quick. Let me jimmy this back out. And somebody installed a power outlet here. So it's a little trickier. Set that right there. So you see a whole mess of wiring here, and you'll see that's the wall to the shower there as well. The black cord you see there is for my GPS. That's actually, I believe, to the actual fish finder cable there. But basically I just pulled out the old harness out there, and now that's connection, so I'm gonna work on wiring it up right now. Alright, so this is the end of Monday, coming out here and installing the sound system on the new boat. Not completely done yet. As you can see, I still have this all tore apart still. But the receiver's hooked up. The amp's hooked up. I have 3 of the 4 speakers, and I have 1 sub hooked up. So the fourth speaker's not hooked up yet. And this is on Bluetooth. And this is only half of the volume level. So, as you can see, I think that is a successful project as of so far. Still got another speaker to add in here and button up all the wiring and mounting this gauge receiver onto that piece of plywood that sits over on that side there when I get done with it. Maybe tomorrow, maybe Wednesday. It is awfully windy out here today. Since I've been out here at the Lake Erie Marina here, Breast Bay Marina for Lake Erie, the water has actually risen to probably about 1.5 feet. In fact, back tires of my car is now in water. That's what happens when we have this easterly wind on Lake Michigan. All that water gets pushed right into us, and our water level goes up. But we had a hell of a time putting the sound system in. It's not done yet, but it sounds pretty damn awesome. All right, guys, I'm on the back here 2 days later. Pretty much finished up the install. As you can see, I put the captain seat back together. Got that receiver mounted right over here on the right side of it. Just on a piece of plywood. As I mentioned before, this whole side has to get rebuilt. That's probably next, maybe this winter's project, maybe. So as you see, I got this speaker. I did get it hooked up and wired up and everything, although it's just sitting like that for now. On the receiver, I did not go ahead and install the remote. As of right now, I don't really see a need for it. Maybe after I get it mounted in the dash, after I build a dash out, I'll go and put that remote in somewhere else in the cabin. But for right now, I felt that was just sufficient. I mean, it's a 30-foot boat, so it's not like I can't get to it at any time. Okay. So we got the speakers running, got everything set up. The only thing I do not have finished is the lighting on the speakers in the sub. I need to just run the electrical on it, and I didn't have any more electrical wire with me today, at least not marine grade anyways. So I'm going to do that, probably do that late in the evening sometime, so when I actually get it set up, I can actually test it properly. One thing I will say, a note though, is that on the amp, after I closed it all up and stuff, it started to cut out. That was because I had it turned all the way up. For the amp. So I actually backed it down to minimum on both the sub and the speakers, played around with it a little bit, and I've actually settled at halfway point for it. It doesn't seem to be cutting out now, so hopefully that will remedy that issue. Also, if you remember I mentioned that rocket, fishing rocket, I went ahead and taped this Dasani bottle here to it, so I'll just have to monitor that every time I get on the boat, if there's water in it or not, and maybe it stays dry, but, you know, with the rain coming down. So I'm signing off. You'll check out these cool pillows and beanbags my wife picked up a while ago with the rug. But it's running pretty good. Let me see if this thing kicks on again here. Corn. Let's see what the next song is. A little Led Zeppelin, so. That, once again, is less than halfway on the receiver and halfway on the amp. All right, signing off.